The largest rocket ever built took flight today in Texas. Ultimately, SpaceX's Starship did not make it back to Earth, but that doesn't mean today was a loss. Our Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heidler is live for us at the Kennedy Space Center this afternoon. And Scott, it's actually being called a success.
Yes, there are a lot of happy teams over at SpaceX. Now, while in the end there were failures with this test mission, the progress it made in this overall process will accelerate, no doubt accelerate, the development of this nearly 400-foot tall rocket system.
Going farther than the two previous test flights last year, Starship's third test flight Thursday morning had a less than explosive conclusion.
This is just absolutely incredible views.
So I don't know if SpaceX in their wildest dreams could have been any happier than how it really happened this morning. So tremendous success.
The largest and most powerful rocket built, the Super Heavy booster with 33 engines separated from the Starship, was able to do a flip maneuver, point itself in the right direction, and do a burn back. While it did make it back to the anticipated splashdown zone in the Gulf of Mexico, it was not the soft landing that was hoped.
The big improvement with the booster stage that we saw in this flight was a successful boost back burn, which is to bring the booster, basically reverse its course and bring it back.
And for the Starship, the payload door was opened in space and a propellant transfer was to be made. They skipped on an engine test. Data for all tests to be analyzed and critical for the role it will play in the future, including a key one in NASA's Artemis program. It'll bring astronauts to the lunar surface in the program's third mission as early as 2026.
We've never seen anything like this before. This is the biggest flying object ever in space.
Absolutely.
An amazing sight as the super hot plasma enveloped Starship's side from friction as it re-entered Earth's atmosphere 40 minutes after liftoff from Boca Chica, Texas. This is when contact was lost with Starship, ultimately being destroyed as it fell back to the surface.
Now SpaceX is going to pour through all of that data, decide what went right and what needs to be worked on more, and then start plotting out test flight number 4 that could come in just the next few months. Reporting live at the Kennedy Space Center, Scott Heidler, WESH 2 News.
Scott, thank you.